Hello everyone and welcome to Game 3 in the series between Gamma Nia Sen versus Donrei Gu. Game 3 taking place here on Cloud Kingdom. Sen has evened up the series at one game apiece now, so this will be the final and deciding match in this best of three series as the games continue. Donrei Gu on the top right hand side as the red Zerg. Meanwhile, Sen as the blue Zerg. And Zerg versus Zerg once more. Would have been really surprised if they even decided to change any of their races. Alright. Now, taking a look at the overall strategy and the overall pacing of the map, there's only one really major walkway between these two bases, and that's up the middle. Now, Zerg players generally will be trying to scout each other out, and Roaches, who are fairly slow in the early portion of the game, will be traveling across the center portion here. Now, your third base does open you up to multiple lines of attack, as opposed to just defending one narrow choke point here. You gotta defend multiple attack points from here, 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 and here as well, as Roaches with very, very high movement speed can deal a lot of damage. So far, it looks like Donrei Gu is going to be opening up with a very aggressive build now, opting to go for an earlier spawning pool. That spawning pool was placed down about 45 seconds ago, so at the 1 minute end, a 1 minute mark almost, and with that, trying to do my math as quickly as I can, that may have been a 9 pool. So far, the extractor is already down as well. So the extractor was placed down after that spawning pool, and metabolic boost could be coming in as we now see an overlord is out and Zerglings already coming in. Now, Sen is going to be in a whole lot of trouble and a whole lot of hurt if he doesn't get that spawning pool down in his next building. If he does get it down, he may be able to fend off this attack here, as the queen and a little bit of defender's advantage will help him out. Zerglings with that metabolic boost, the overlord is in position. It will be scouting out these Zerglings here in just a second, and here they come in a single file line. What is Sen going to do to react and respond? He sees the Zerglings, he knows that they're there, and now knows that he needs to defend. No hatchery down over here at all, obviously at this point, as the hatchery up here on the high ground, or excuse me, on the low ground, may get destroyed. Now, let's take a look over here. The queen's larva still only has one larva available. That is a bit of a curious situation. I thought he would have at least 2 to 3 at this point to be able to defend against these Zerglings. 6 Zerglings now slashing away at this hatchery. Is the hatchery, yes, going to get canceled? Now trying to get back up as metabolic boost has been started by Donrei Gu. The drone now trying to wander around and trying to stay alive as the drones of Sen now trying to stick together as well. And the drones of Sen, oh, doing a beautiful flank there, taking down a good number of Zerglings. And now we do have Zerglings out for Sen. So Sen, so far, has he lost that much? Harvester count is 11 to 15. Donrei Gu does have some Zerglings inside the main base, but he is very, very far behind at this point. But at least he will have metabolic boost sometime soon. Meanwhile, it looks like Sen is not going to be getting that. Oh, Sen is already starting his own metabolic boost. So only about a minute difference here as we now see some Zerglings down here on the low ground. Sen establishing up a second queen. A second queen as one queen now coming down over here. Going to be staying right here on the ramp. I believe that's what Sen needs to do with this queen. That queen can stay on the ramp, it will be able to keep sight and also use that those very, very long talons of hers to get some additional DPS. So far, we see a whole bunch of Zerglings coming back over. Donrei Gu know about it? Yes, Donrei Gu does see the reestablishment of this hatchery, and the Zerglings are going to be trying to surround it and take it down once more. Zerglings now trying to make their way up, and here you go. There is a queen on the ramp, and two queens on the ramp, slashing away. The Zerglings know that they cannot engage this and come out ahead, so the Zerglings and the queens are just engaging in a better position every time it is possible. The queens, with that additional range, really helping out, as those Zerglings are just more there as a meat shield. But in comes some more Zerglings. This could be a bad move. Sen may have overexposed himself just a little bit too much, as those Zerglings are going to get a very good surround here. Sen, is she going to be able to get off one key inject? Yes, it looks like it will be able to do so, as the Zerglings are making their way inside. Harvester count is 14 to 11, as the Zerglings of Donrei Gu have pretty much awesome sight inside the base. Zerglings now need to come back over. Oh, is it going to be enough? No, the queen does go down, so heavy production. reduction loss for Sen. Meanwhile, Donrei Gu does have enough, and now we see the counterattack possibly coming in. Sen, training up a whole bunch of units, has a lot of minerals and resources now, and the larva count. What is he gonna do? Training up a queen at each of the bases, or has a queen at each of the bases, and now we're gonna see an engagement from Sen. Sen trying to run inside, gonna be able to do so. There's only one queen out, as the queens and the Zerglings are engaging. Sen gets the surround and the GG from Donrei Gu, and Sen takes this best of three series after losing game one. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed game three in this best of three from the TESL Summer 2012 Finals show match between Gamma Nia Sen and Donrei Gu.